Welcome, it's Facts You Don't Know. If it's your first time here and you want to find out new facts that will definitely make you smarter and more, well, and first make sure to subscribe and activate the notification bell so you don't miss anything.
The definition of love is somewhat perplexed. Sometimes people think that love is the final cycle of life. However, this thought is wrong. This is because there are many physical, psychological, and mental losses that may be invoked by various love story ends. Thus, it's obvious that the concept of love appears as a possible contributor to different diseases. Nevertheless, true love is generally considered as the only type of love, which ends in a happy, expected way. Hence, it's important not to judge any love tale ending without knowing its minute details and conditions. Undoubtedly, a big number of poor lovers suffer a lot due to their excessive affectionate feelings. On the other hand, the other side may have no idea of such suffering and agony. This is what's called a one-sided love. This story will tackle love according to the thought that the end justifies the means. Igor was a wise, smart, successful, and hopeful young man. He worked as an employee. At work, he was known with his skills, cleverness, and hard working. He was married to his cousin, Maria. Igor loved Maria so much, he was ready to do anything for her. On the other hand, Maria did not return such love back. She had no emotive feelings towards Igor. She was obliged to marry him in order not to disobey her mother's wish. Though they've been married since a long time, Maria did not become pregnant anymore. In fact, she took birth control pills so as to not give birth to any child. She did not want to have a baby from Igor. In spite of Maria's permanent mistreatment towards her husband, Igor, he did not give up. Instead, he always endeavored to make her satisfied and happy. Igor often brought Maria various gifts and souvenirs. All Igor desired was to see Maria in love with him. He told her, "You are the only woman that makes my heart beat fastly. Even though many girls admired me intensively, I have chosen you. I deserve your love, Maria. Tell me what I can do to move your heart." Maria replied in complete indifference, "I live with you only because my mother wished that. In fact, I cannot communicate with you according to a wife-husband relationship. I have never sensed any real emotions to you. This is not my guilt, as I'm a human being after all. No one can direct his feelings as he wills. But we have no control over our heart processes. It's out of hand to fall in love with you. I have no choice doing that. Unfortunately, I am sure I will not be able to love you someday, Igor." Igor responded, "Despite your pessimistic ideas and expectations, I will hold hope and optimism no matter how." Actually, Igor was a patient and persistent true lover. Anyone in his place would abandon the woman immediately. Alliteratively, Igor was a vivid example of a true, genuine love, which cannot be affected by any external impacts. Maria betrayed Igor through being in love with her ex-boyfriend. When Igor was at work, Maria called her intimate companion to come to her house. She exploited Igor's absence badly to feel free with her illegitimate lover. Maria was a symbol of a bad and unfaithful wife who cheated her honest husband with a complete persuasion and an absolute courage. She argued with her lover boldly, "You are my true man. As for Igor, he's the foolish one. Even though I confessed to him my hate towards him, he still chased me and followed me continuously. I wish I would not have listened to my mother anymore. She's the reason why I live a hated and hopeless with Igor. Regarding you, you are my only consoler, dear." Igor happened to return back home in order to take his bag, which he forgot to take. As he entered the apartment, he heard a voice of a stranger coming from Maria's room. He went mad, opening the room door. He found Maria's boyfriend laying on the bed beside Maria. Igor went more crazy, stating loudly at them, "Oh, bad traitors, how dare you cheat me, Maria? I sacrificed everything for your sake. In fact, you are a disloyal woman. You waited me to go out to commit your infidelity and betraying freely and properly. Now I hate you to the moon and back and will take revenge at once. I will kill both of you." Maria's paramour brought a big stick and hit poor Igor in the head very strongly and cruelly. Then Maria and her boyfriend fled immediately. Igor's head bled heavily. He was taken to the hospital by some neighbors. Igor suffered from a deep psychological shock due to such horrible happenings, causing him to be such like a psychopath. He wanders streets aimlessly, uttering understandable words. He looked like a silly man saying nonsense. Igor was completely changed both internally and externally. His face seemed fearful, as his beard was too long. His skin was too dusty and his hair was too long and full of dirt. He seemed as a homeless beggar. On the other side of the story, there was a man named Andros. Andros was an ex-criminal. He had a permanent disability and one of his eyes was totally ruined. He was poor, riotous, trivial, and naughty. He lost his eye in a riot, in which he was the real thug. Igor used to stay regularly in the street in which Andros dwelled. Andros always made fun of Igor and mocked him, until he had a great interest in Igor. So, violently, Andros arranged an evil plot against Igor. Cruel Andros intended to go to the doctor, asking him to take one of Igor's eyes to be planted into Andros's lost one. Igor woke up during the operation, and he heard why the doctor explained to his assistants what they would do with Igor. But he would not even move, as his body was wholly numb. The operation was successfully performed. Poor Igor had no idea of what happened to him. Evil Andros enjoyed his life now. He decided to marry his lover, Manya, at last. Manya did not oppose the inhumane action Andros did against Igor. Instead, she encouraged him greatly. In fact, Manya was a traitor. She cheated on Andros with another man. The gang boss, in which Andros was an effective member, revealed his wish of taking some of Igor's body organs. Andros decided to make use of the situation, as he was a true opportunist. He replied, "I will accept your question on the condition that you give me a big amount of money as a return. This is a dangerous deed, and if the police know about it, we'll be arrested." Both of them agreed together to do the mission as soon as possible. Sudden tidings were brought to Andros that Manya cheated him. Andros was stunned at such news. He went to Manya and scolded her badly, expressing, "Why a foolish creature? I think that Igor is the fool, but now you prove to be the real foolish one. I hate you as much as I loved you. You do not appreciate what risks I've taken to collect the money needed for our marriage preparations. I consider you as my other half, and you appeared as the faithful, ugly woman. From now on, do not contact me again. From now on, do not contact me again, insect. Sooner or later, revenge will be taken. I will show you your real position." Andros decided to take revenge from the traitor, Manya, via killing her and giving her body organs to the boss gang instead of Igor's. Andros killed Manya in a brutal way, and he sold her dead body to the boss. Meanwhile, the police reached the place of receiving and arrested all the criminals. In the police station, Andros confessed all his previous criminal acts, stating, "I've committed several brutal crimes. I deserve to be imprisoned forever. I blame now myself for any inhumane deed I committed, especially what I did to the poor, miserable Igor. Instead of sympathizing with him and helping him to be cured, I made the worst of him deliberately, without having any kind of mercy. I stole his eye with the cooperation of my indecent doctor, who had no morals of the job of being a doctor. O Savior, forgive my sins. I repent now in front of all people. It seems to be my ultimate downfall." The police ordered to arrest the doctor at once. The police officer cooperated with a charity to help Igor be cured. Actually, Igor was taken to a large psychiatric facility. Finally, Igor was recovered successfully. Igor thanks his doctor's expression, "I am aware gratefully for your great efforts exerted to render me sane and sound as before." Life's beauty is that it always provides a second opportunity. Life might surprise us with another chance at any time, offering us the opportunity to attempt something new, to reinvent ourselves, and to begin again. The trouble is that we either lose hope out on that opportunity by holding on to a past failure, a tale with no happy ending, or we willfully refuse to embrace it, sentencing ourselves to a life of failure. Life is made up of choices, as it always is, and our success is determined by how well we take advantage of the opportunities that life provides. Life could have taken away people we loved and things we loved. Relationships might have ended abruptly. We might have never succeeded, and having something or doing something special, the life we used to have, could have vanished in the blink of an eye. We could have lost many things. But life has taken away from us people we loved and things we loved. Relationships could have ended abruptly, and we could have never succeeded at having something or doing something special. The life we used to have could have vanished in the blink of an eye. We could have lost. Life will offer us a second opportunity no matter what has occurred in the past or how many errors we have made. But we must remember that a second chance does not erase the repercussions of our previous actions. Any prior decision, behavior, or action will have ramifications. But a second opportunity indicates that we have the option to do things differently. We have the ability to transform ourselves into a better version of ourselves. We can make alternative choices, learn from our errors, and do things differently in order to improve ourselves and others around us. A second chance is simply that, the opportunity to make a better tomorrow. But what if I didn't make any mistakes at all? What if life was simply unkind to me and took something I treasured away from me? What happens when a person loses a loved one, a career, a home, or anything else they care about? What occurs when someone goes undergone a traumatic experience? Will this second chance provide us with the opportunity to reclaim what we once had? Well, it varies. Sometimes a second opportunity does not imply that we will get exactly what we had before, simply because something greater awaits us. From my experience, I've learned that life never takes without giving back. Things happen so that we might have another shot at living a better life and being the person we were meant to be. That's why it's critical to believe in life and to wait for that second chance to reinvent our lives. Because if we live in the past, we will never have the opportunity to see this second chance. It will pass us by, and we will be too blinded by our past to see it. Thanks for watching. Please like and share the video in social networks. We'll be right back to you as fast as we can.